So, my name is Il-Hyun from South Korea. We usually say Korea, but I recognize a lot of British people discriminate Korea, South Korea, and North Korea. How many of you actually met North Koreans here? Not many, right?
Okay.
So, I know you're more interested in the research and development insight for the MOOCs. But we are quite recent in terms of the MOOC development and implementation in Korea. And the Korean MOOC is highly culturally contextualized into Korean higher education system. So I'd like to spend more time to share with you what is Korean higher education look like, what kind of problems we have, and what kind of implications or potentials that learning analytics can bring us to solve those Korean problems. How many of you have heard, before I start, what is your general impression of the Korean education? No idea?
Very limited.
Very limited. Anybody?
Very competitive.
Competitive. That is one thing that I'm going to discuss. And how many of you heard the PISA test ranking? I mean, that's like a global ranking for like 15-year-old kids all around the world. Korea is always on the top five or top three in maths and science. Right? So our students are very good in terms of test scores. I emphasize test scores, right? That does not necessarily mean they are actual learning. And that problem for high school or middle school has been cascading to the university level. So the problems of Korean higher education cannot be understood if you do not know the Korean economic and cultural situations in general. Thus, the Korean MOOC, which is in its early stage, will be quite different in terms of its way of implementation and its strategy for effective design. Okay, so I'd like to share more for what Korean students look like. Oh, also, PISA reports two different domains of ranking. One is for like academic outcome, the other one is motivation. Korean students, 15-year-olds, always on the top five, but they are always on the bottom below five in terms of their motivation. That means Korean students are very good at in scores, in math and science, but for some reason they really hate to study. Okay. My academic training always emphasized the importance of motivation, because people believe motivation is the strongest predictor for the learning. But in Korea, I don't think that is how it works in Korea. There must be some reason, right? So. Without understanding the Korean situation, we might not be effectively design and develop our own MOOC, right? And we cannot be successful. Maybe you do not have a lot of interest in what's happening in Korea, but I think from my experience, learning analytics is trying to develop some kind of a predictive modeling, right? But each universities are different in terms of their way of teaching and learning. So maybe the Korean case could provide you, there should be such a different learning happen somewhere in your institute too. Okay.
Okay.
In Korea, we have about like almost 350 higher education institutions in Korea, right? And when you say universities, that is more like a 4-year teaching and research university institute. College means more like a 2-year and more vocationally oriented institutions. So, is it large enough? Okay. But when I was in my college years in early 80s, there were, at that time there was like less than 50 higher education institutes in Korea. At that time, only 50% of senior high school students went to the higher education. These days, more than 80% seniors of high school go to the universities. So that means a lot of issues in Korean higher education in terms of the quality of learning. And we think the learning analytics could provide very critical, very like effective and practical solution to the problems that we are facing in Korea. Okay, the student faculty number, the ratio is 1 to 30, right? And the problem here is the Korean universities trying to respond to the social needs. The social needs mostly come from like economic situation. This is the employment rate of Korean higher education graduate. So about like 67% of the graduates are getting job right after their graduation. Is it similar to you?
96.
How much?
In the 90s for Kings.
Yeah, 90s. Mm. Yeah. But the problem is, like for example, Ewha is known as one of the prestigious university, and the good schools like Seoul National University or Yonsei or Korea, the employment rate of those prestigious universities are not quite higher than average universities. Do you know why? Because Korean students are highly selective. I mean, if they have to go less paying or less decent job, they rather not get a job and stay in their school and extend their college life for like 1 or 2 years. So on average, the students spend more than 5 years to get undergraduate diploma. Not because they are lazy, but because they want to have the largest opportunity to get into a good job like a Samsung Electronics. So that is why even the top high school, top university in Korea, like Seoul National, their employment rate is around like 60 or 70. I mean, actually my only daughter is graduating from KCL. She is at the Denmark here?
Denmark.
Yeah. So I know this is good school, but is 90% is average employment rate for the British students here?
King's is one of the best, I think.
Oh, yeah. How come my daughter is still looking for?
Okay.
You know what happened this year? So that is the Korean, the general test. And the competition is coming from high school. I mean, the Korean higher education, the universities are very competitive. But the competition began before they come to university, because we have like a national standardized test for something called a college scholastic ability test. That's once a year, like almost like 500,000 high school seniors take the same course, same test in the same day. So if they fail, if they are not very, very well on the test day, they lose opportunity to go to good university. So, and Korean, math, English, social studies, and those are the major subject matters. So all the kids in Korea is trying their best to get highest score from those subject matters. That means they actually do not care too much about those subjects that are not being tested. This is a picture taken from private prep school in Korea. Can you see what is your impression from this picture?
Very large class.
Large class, yeah. And what they are doing? Are they going to talk to each other, collaborating, or like a discussion? I mean, most of the instructional strategy, most of us are talking about like a collaborative, like a project-based learning, or like constructivist learning environment, right? But what actually happening in Korean classrooms are something like this. This is taken at like a 10 p.m. Yeah?
Yeah.
Not British time, Korean time. Yeah. After their regular class, they go to the restaurant and eat, and they have to get on the bus. The bus is waiting for the high school kids to bring to like a private test prep academy. So they start their real study after their work in regular classrooms. Okay?
So this is in the evening, right?
Yeah. So they don't have to talk about each other. Because I mean the test items are contained in standardized textbooks. So what they have to do is reading and solving the problems that are shown on the textbook. What is your textbook system in high school? In Korea, the Korean Ministry of Education published the nationally standardized textbooks. So every seniors is studying same textbook and taking same national college entrance test, and when they earn that scores, they go to university. Okay. So, and these are pictures taken from mother's session. While their kids are studying in the evening class, their mothers participate in like a consultant's workshop, and the consultation is for how the children can find best. So this is for they're watching a consultant's presentation for how to get best university in Korea. The kids do not have a lot of time to participate, so their mothers instead go there. I mean this is like a general trends. There are a lot of students and families, parents, they want to provide like a really creative learning environment, of course. But on average, this is the situation in Korea. And this situation brings us a lot of problems in instructional teaching and learning in university. First one is internal motivation issue. The students who are very smart did not have a lot of opportunity to experience internally motivated learning, right? That is one thing. So second one is like a lack of self-regulation, or like a metacognition. Because what they had to do was I mean, their books are given, and they do not have to too much worry about establishing learning strategies or managing their own learning. So those kind of self-regulatory capability and internal motivation should be provided while they are staying in higher education. So that is the challenge that we have in the universities in Korea. Do you think your student in KCL is highly internally motivated to learn? You know, we are all like teachers or professors. We are not so supposed to be satisfied with as is students, right? And then what about the self-regulation? Do you think your students are highly self-regulating, like metacognitively strategic thinkers?
It might depend on the discipline.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I think it's strategic learners in that they're very focused on what they need to do to assessment.
Right.
But they're not, I think they also easily get distracted because of the age they are and, you know, there are a lot of excitements in London.
In Korea, professors believe that college students, especially for male students, are wasting a lot of time for like a gaming, you know, the games. So in Korea, the female students are regarded as better students than males, especially in co-ed university. But my institute is women's university, so 100% of students are women. They do not do a lot of game. So they spend their most of time learning and preparing themselves to take tests in my class. So that brings another problem to our institutes.
Okay,
when they are successful, Korean students go to the university. And in the Korean university, the research indicates the most, the largest problem, the complaints that students have was the lack of feedback from instructors to the students. I mean, one of my colleagues did some like comparative analysis with that of the Korean student and US. This indicates Korean students think Korean instructors are the university faculty members do not provide enough feedback. What do you think in UK situation?
Some of the, I guess, pieces of feedback you get from the student surveys is
But I think he conducted some interview with the students, and he found why Korean students think they have less they are receiving not enough feedback from instructors. The one is the Korean students' expectation of the feedback from instructors are from their experience from private tutoring academy, where they spend like more than like 1,000 pound, pound per month, because that is like a private institute, and they get paid a lot, so they had a lot of like a teaching assistants, and the students in my university is always comparing me with her tutor in the private university. in the private test prep school with like dozens of teaching instructors, teaching assistants. And the other big problem in Korean college is the score, the evaluation system. Right? Do you know, are you familiar with this? We call it like a comparative scoring system. So in the class, certain percent of students should get A, B, and C. So that means that such as like the top university like Ewha, where only like a top 3% of students come to, I have to mark at least 30% of students with C or below, no matter how they work hard. So this brings a lot of problem to Korean higher education. Is it acceptable in your institute? So in terms of learning analytics, this situation brings us a lot of challenges, because most of the learning analytics, which have like a prediction model, the like outcome measure could be either like a learning outcome or retention rate, right? But in Korea, retention rate is not a problem because nobody drops out. They just stay there, right? So dropout is not a relevant outcome measure. But the other one, which is learning outcome or learning performance, is problematic because of this. Every semester, that is the most difficult time for me, because sometimes students come to my office complain, right? But if I want her score to go up from B to A, then means I have to find one sacrifice who should go down. This system provides a lot of problems in the way of providing feedback. For example, when I first joined the Ewha about 10 years ago, I gave my students a lot of feedback. I usually conduct 8 or 7 times of quizzes for the semester. So whenever I grade them, I just made copies of it and get the copy to each of the students. So that means that means I'm very good at providing feedback, right? But at the end of the semester, I had a lot of complaints from my students because they have been getting my feedback and they knew their scores out of 8 quizzes, so they operate their own prediction model by asking their colleagues, what was your score? What was your score? And they create their own prediction model, and if my at end of the semester grades is below their expectation, then they bring their scores with their colleagues to my office complaining what happened. Right? The other one, I sometimes, I mean, when I conduct like a short essay test, I give them like a feedback, written feedback, with scores on it, and I send it, and then I give it back to each student for the feedback purpose, and my smart students again compare their scores with their colleagues and try to find my inconsistency in grading, and if they find, they also come to my office complaining. So that means from like an instructor's point of view, it could be like a, it could be if I provide a lot of feedback that make myself in more like a riskier situation. So that means the lack of feedback, the subjective perception of Korean student lack of feedback from instructors are coming from two. One is their experience from high school in like a prep school. The other one is the one that I said. I mean, professors in Korea, even though they have time and energy to provide feedback, they sometimes should hesitate. Okay?
In terms of your marking criteria, is that quite fixed, or can you be quite flexible with your criteria?
Yeah. I mean, in Korea, the high school students are preparing themselves for like a nationally standardized curriculum and standardized test. But university classrooms are different, right? We professors want to have dominate my own class. I design the course. I present the material. I develop the testing item. And I should monopolize. And I want to have the authority to give the grades to them in like 30, 20 years ago. But not now, we cannot do that. I mean, and the problem is, in these days, Korea is like, IT is very, I mean 100% of my students are bringing some types of like computer device, like a smartphone or laptop or iPad, anything. And the problem is, I recently realized most of the students are taking records, my lecture or my announcement or like my like chatting in the classroom without my permission. I was really, isn't it scary? So they try to record what I talk and try to conduct research to like a comparison analysis with their colleagues, right? Why should they do that? Why Korean students are so competitive in getting high score, high GPAs? Because the employment. I mean, Korean economy is not growing as fast as 1980s. When I was in college, nobody worried about getting a job. I mean, I was not very good student. Even I could pick Samsung. I picked Samsung, not they picked me. Samsung and like a big banks always come to Seoul National and try to seduce us to bring them back to their office at that time. But these days, the situation is different. And they have to make their GPAs almost perfect. Then they can have opportunity to find a decent job in these days in Korean business community. That is why they want to get the high school, I mean, okay, another one. My students come to my office to correct their
their mark, and they and most of them, their most of the marks that I gave them was like a minus. Is A minus good enough? Right? At that time, I was like a C plus student when I was in college, and I didn't worry about that. But this is my student, even those who have like ambitions, who have like a lot of like energy and like dreams, they always want to have A zero or A plus. So A minus, they cannot accept it. But again, if I want to make her from A minus to A plus, then I have to make Andy, who was A plus, down to A minus, according to the system. Yes, yes. And this is, and okay. And because the Korean economy is highly, highly, what can I say? The economic growth rate is not high enough these days. Korean employers try to have top-notch students from the classes, from the universities. So, Korean, the faculty members and management of higher education have some motivation to inflate the scores, the GPAs of their students. So, and the Korean Ministry of Education was suspicious for the student, for the universities of evaluation practices. So by law, they impose us to follow the curve. Okay. So, the learning analytics, because, I mean, most of the learning analytics research, the unit of analysis is a certain class, right? Most of the time, the learning analytics try to make the maximum learning out of a high school, a higher education classroom. But as I said, in Korea, it is so competitive, and because of the curve-based grading system, individual classroom learning analytics may not be very helpful for the students and the instructors. So, at Ewha, our learning analytics is more for like a 4-year college years. So, the unit of analysis is not a classroom or not a class, but the 4-year collegiate experience. That means the Ewha learning analytics, we call it like e-portfolio system, is predicting individual students' employability as outcome variable. Not GPA, but their employability. So, for example, every semester, college undergraduate students take like 9 or 7, 8 classes. So, we put all of the student behavior out of LMS or MOOC or VLE. You more familiar with VLEs, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, VLEs, and put them together and try to predict which course should each student take for the greater likelihood of getting job when they get graduated. So our unit of analysis is like the collegiate experience, including extracurriculars. So, these the screenshot of the newly developed e-portfolio system in Ewha, and we collect all the data from VLEs and from their like SIS, for example, like student information system, and even their higher school, even their records from high schools, we put them together and try to make like a long-term prediction for their employability, and then we provide their like recommendation system for which course should you take to increase your likelihood of employability at the end of your graduation. So that is quite different perspective of Korean learning analytics in higher education. And the other one, why we are interested in learning analytics is that the students and the professors, as I said, was kind of worried about being complained by students. So instead of personally providing feedback, we thought that like a kind of like an algorithm or data-driven feedback could be better, could make like an automated feedback system which will help the library instructors in more like a less labor intensive and also less like a riskier situation. So this is the research model of my lab, and my student and I'm studying and researching on the learning analytics based on the data from Ewha. And also these days, because of the motivation was a very important learning outcome for us in Korea, instead of putting the behavioral data, I use a lot of like sensor data. Are you familiar with like eye tracking or like heart rate or like galvanic stimulant, the like skin conductance, those kind of sensor based psychophysiological data could provide us the evaluation and prediction of like emotional and motivational character, motivational situation of each learners, which could provide us a better chance to understand and help individual students. Yeah, this is the snapshot of my experiment. Okay, and this is the results. A few the list of recent research results, and this is the workshop that we conducted based on the learning analytics data from Ewha, and that we had a large audience who wanted to come and learn from our experience. So in Korea, the learning analytics is expected as a decision support system for mass customization of learning. And second one is it is expected to serve as a evaluation as beginning awareness in learning design. And third one is actually it's a challenge for us because learning analytics, which is based on individual learners' behavior and physiological variations, we need to think about the ethics and those kind of power or political issues. These are challenges for us. But I think we are in the very beginning of the research and research and development. But early this year we opened the e-portfolio system for the 20,000 Ewha students, and as the data collected and as the algorithm getting refined, I think this learning analytics approach could provide us very critical and practical implications to the specific characteristics of Korean higher education.